SEO for real estate agents or real estate agents. You might be a real estate agent yourself trying to improve your website visibility in Google, or you might be someone like me who does SEO for different people and different businesses. I have a client that is a estate agent. Some time ago, I remember myself searching for information about real estate agent SEO. So now that I know how to do it, I'm gonna show you guys how you can do it.
Yeehaw!
This is actually my first video on YouTube. I tried to record my first video and this is how it went. Now I want to make a video. I want to make a video because I want everyone to see it. I don't know what I'm talking about. So who are your potential SEO clients as a state agent? Every action or challenge you face when you do SEO should always be oriented back to your business goals and real life goals. That's what always comes first, and then SEO follows. The point to do SEO is to gain visibility and turn that visibility into clients. So in simple words, SEO has to make you money. Having said that, as a real estate agent, you're trying to align what your potential clients are searching for in Google with what you offer as a business and convince them to buy from you by offering them value when they most need it. At the end of the day, SEO is just good old marketing, trying to sell. To do that, you need to know who your potential clients are. To answer a question, you need to ask yourself more questions.
What part of the world are your clients from? How old are they? How much money do they have? What problem or need do they have that you can solve? How much are they willing to spend to resolve this problem?
And the reason why you need to ask yourself these questions is to make an informed decision when you try to find what these people search for in Google, which is the next step. This action is actually called making an SEO buyer persona. If you don't know who you're selling to, you are completely lost. Now that you have a broader view of the spectrum of people that you want to target, let's do some SEO. The best free SEO tools for state agents. It's absolutely possible to do SEO for free. You just need to know where to find these tools and most of the time how to play around with their freemium features. And these are the 8 tools we're gonna use for this video.
Uber suggests the free Moz plan, a Chrome extension called SEO Minion, another extension called Keyword Surfer, Ahrefs free backlink checker to do link building. That's the last point in the video. And the 2 secret tools I'm gonna give you as you watch along.
Real estate agent keyword research. So it's time to find out what your clients, potential clients, really want. So how are we gonna do this? We're going to see what they search for, how many times they search for it, what do they want to see when they search for it, and if you should make a page for this keyword or not. You first need to know what seed keywords are. A seed keyword in SEO is the most general word or set of words that can describe your business. You can normally find seed keywords asking yourself these questions. I will use my real estate agent client as an example throughout this video. So our set of seed keywords are, the more seed keywords you have, the more of the others we're gonna find. I'm gonna tell you about the others. Let's go and hunt some more keywords. Hunt. To do this, we're gonna use UberSuggest, the free plan from Moz, and the first secret tool I have for you, which is my own template that I use myself with my clients. You're gonna use this template throughout the whole video, and you can download it in the link in my description. All you have to do is click the link, you will find the template, and make a copy of it. It's a Google Sheets template, and once you have your own copy, you can personalize it and follow through with this video. The first tool we're gonna use is UberSuggest, and what this tool does, it gives you keyword ideas and suggestions when you feed it a seed keyword. So what you have to do is type one of your seed keywords, like property for sale, and search. So you can see you have the monthly volume and other types of information. But what we want to focus right now is in the suggestions it gives you, keyword ideas. So you click view all keywords and export to CSV. And you can see it has downloaded the keyword ideas. What you want to do now is to import the suggested keywords from UberSuggest. So you press File, Import, Upload, Add the CSV file. And then press Insert in New Sheet, Port Data. And this is what we have now, okay? Select the keyword column and the search volume. And with Control pressed, press the keyword and the search volume because we don't want that. And copy. go to the keyword research, put it here. The sheet I've given you, it has already a conditional format, which is going to make the highest volume keywords green and the lowest red. So it will be way easier to identify the high volume keywords when you have a whole list of them, which is what we're going to do next. What you want to do is do the same using the most free version. It's a bit more powerful. It actually gives you keyword based on relevancy, and it's just the same thing as Uber suggests. Export CSV and then import it the same way we've done. It's easy, right? So the same thing, you have to put your seed keywords and do the same process with Uber suggest and Moz. When you finish this, you're gonna have a huge list of keywords, which is exactly what we want. We want a list so big that you get scared. You're going to be like, whoa, I have to go through all these keywords. Don't worry, that's why we're gonna use filtering. So what I want you to do now is filter them with the most popular keywords on the top. You select the whole sheet, create a filter. We got our seed keywords. We searched them in the tools. We got suggestions. We want to do the same with the most popular suggestions. So for example, looking around, I found that cheap flats for sale is a keyword that is relevant to my business. I offer flats, cheap, and they're for sale. So we pick that keyword and then we put it in our tools again. With this, you can imagine the monstrous amount of keywords we're gonna get, and it's exactly what we want. The more keywords you have, the more you know about your potential clients and what they're searching for in Google. The next point within our keyword research is, what are king keywords and prince keywords? And no, this is not a real SEO term. This is something I invented myself. But I always like to make weird analogies and examples with things. I feel they stick better in my head when I do it. I like to call king keywords to the most popular keyword that acts as a tip of the iceberg for a specific topic. Let me give you an example. Within the topic of buying a property in Spain, we have three keywords. And as you can see, property for sale in Spain is the most popular keyword, which means this one is the king keyword and the other two are the prince keywords. Prince keywords are variations of the king. Other ways of searching for the topic of buying a property in Spain. Now that you know the theory, or my theory, about these two types of keywords, let's continue with our keyword research. First, you need to look at the huge keyword list you have in your sheet and get rid of any that are not relevant for your business. If you don't sell houses in Cornwall, then we don't want that in your list. The next step is to find the king and the prince keywords within your list. To do this, you have to group the keywords that have the same intention or the same topic. Go to your huge keyword list and ask yourself, why do people search this? What do they want to see? So a way to know what people want is to search it in Google. And I can straight away see that people, when they search this, people are looking for information rather than buying. They're not looking to buy properties, rural properties in the UK, but rather information. So now, from all your list of keywords, you have filtered the ones that are not relevant for you, and you have grouped them into intention. Whew. So right now you might be wondering, why do I need to do this? It's very simple. You want to optimize the page you're going to create to target the king keyword. Then you can add or sprinkle any of your prince keywords within that same page. I'm going to show you how to optimize your page in step 5. So if you're following along, you might be wondering, how can I know if I should make a specific page for a keyword? You have to see if your SEO competitors are actually doing pages for this topic or keyword. To do this, you have to search both keywords in Google and check out what you see. If both keywords give you similar results, then it's not worth making a specific page about that. And here is where I show you the second mystery tool. The same way you downloaded the template, the link is in the description. The same thing is a Google Sheet. Let's get into it. This tool is gonna tell you the differences between one SERP and another. Another tool, in this case, one of the Chrome extensions called SEO Minion. The reason why we need this tool is because we need to scrape or extract the search engine results page into our sheets. Let me show you in the screen. Go to Google and search both of your keywords. Then, when you've downloaded your Chrome extension, you have to go here and press go. Now you've copied the first 50 results. Then you have to go to the new sheets I've given you and paste it. Now do the same for the other keyword. So you might be thinking, what does this tool actually do? So as you can see here, some of the results have gotten red. So any of these that have turned red are also in the second column. So this saves you a lot of time because in this case, both keywords show a few similar results, meaning this page is showing for property tax in Spain and capital gain tax in Spain, but there aren't that many duplicates, which means it might be worth to create a page specifically about this. Another example of this with keywords with buying intention will be with property for sale in Alicante and property for sale in Alicante with swimming pool. Should I make a specific page for my houses in Alicante or wherever you are with swimming pools, or will my general page with properties also rank for the with swimming pools version? Haha, look what we got here. You can see that everything is red almost. This tool saves you a lot of time because you can see everything visualized in 1 second. You can see how we saw it very fast that this is not worth doing it. Imagine doing it without this tool, you will have to go one by one with both windows open, trying to see if one page is also showing in the other one. It's a real time saver. And the keyword research is done. The next points are gonna be way faster. And you've gone from SEO level 1 to SEO level 37. And most importantly, I'm gonna start a weekly newsletter with all the articles and learning resources I have found that week. So basically, this newsletter is gonna have everything I use to learn SEO for free for you. Sign up to my newsletter that is in the description. You're gonna learn super SEO. I do SEO and I actually learned most of it online, and it's possible to learn it online. And I want to make sure that my channel and my blog and my website that you can check in the description really offers value. So let's get into it. Point number 4 is SEO content research for real estate agents. What we're going to see in this point is what your competitors have created, and to establish how to create something more valuable. This is super important. Step number 1 is to go to the on-page tab in your sheet. Then you have to search your king keyword in Google and scrape, like we've done before, the search engine results. So for example, we're gonna use the keyword property for sale in Altea. It's a popular touristic town here in Spain. Type it and then copy the results. Now, I want you to scan each website to find out what they are about and what content do they have. But most importantly, I want you to ask yourself this question. How does this page answer the intention of the person who searches for property for sale in Altea? With this specific keyword, you can see that most of the top results actually show you a list of properties in the area. If you do this correctly, your probabilities of ranking high are gonna go up stratospherically, regardless of your website's authority or amount of links you have, because this is exactly what Google wants. Pages that answer the intention of the user. By the way, link building for real estate agents is the last step in this video. With my own client, when I created the page for the keyword property for sale in Altea, I saw something very interesting. Most of the top results were taken by websites with sheer power, authority, and amount of links. There's not much you can do about that. However, their content sometimes was inexistent, or they just had vague or mostly irrelevant text about the beaches in Altea or the restaurants in the area.
Do people who search for property for sale in Altea want to know about beaches?
Well, maybe. Or do you think they would rather know about buying property in this area? I mean, they've literally told you what they want. Their intention is to buy a house. So let's give them valuable information throughout their own journey to buying a house. And who knows, they might even buy from you. For you to see, I created a page with property listings in this area and valuable information like, now that's more helpful than knowing about the restaurants in Altea. Although they're pretty nice, I've been there. Point number 5 is SEO on page. The only thing you need to know is that the reason to do SEO on page is for your website to make it clear to Google what it is about. There's a lot of websites that don't do this correctly, so doing this is going to definitely give you an advantage. So the first point is to write the content. The second point is to make the content readable using short paragraphs and bullet lists. If you make the content easier to digest, it means that they're going to stay longer in your page, and this is a signal for Google that people are liking your page. Add the most important information and keywords at the beginning of the page. Surround your titles with an HTML tag called H, which basically tells Google that this is a title. Add between 2 or 5 links to other authoritative websites where it makes sense. For example, if you have a page about taxes, you might send people to a website about how to do a specific tax in that country, a government website. Add a minimum of 3 links to other internal pages in your website. The next point is to make your meta titles inciting. Make sure that people click. Also add your king keyword in the title. To make sure your title is inciting and that it makes people click, check the other titles your competitors have and try to make it stand out. For example, I created a page about the Spanish property market and I found out that adding the year and a question will make it more inciting. With your images, make sure the images you use in your page are relevant, compressed, and that the name of the file and the alt attribute of the image has keywords on it. Finally, and I will make another video specifically about that, add schema markup. With my client, I added a schema markup called FAQ, and the result of this is getting this nice box with the questions. Obviously, this is really good because it makes my result way bigger than the competitors. Now, your content is easier to consume by your readers and way easier to understand for search engines. Link building for real estate agents. From the 200 plus factors that Google uses to rank websites, links are still the most powerful one. Think of people linking to your website as votes in Google's eyes. This factor is completely ingrained in Google's algorithm from the beginning, and it's called page rank. And no, it's not page as on your page, but rather as one of Google's founders called Larry Page. The more links your website and pages have, the higher your page rank is, and the more worthy you are to rank. So let's get to it. We're almost finished, guys. I want you to look at the list of competitors we scraped from the web when you did your content research. In this case, to make the example more clear, I'm going to use the keyword about taxes, which is the one I use with my client. You can see here my 10 top competitors for the keyword property taxes in Spain. Now, I want you to open the last tool on this video, which is the Ahrefs free backlink checker. What this tool does is it checks the top 100 links to that page. Let's check this example. This was a competitor. It has 30 websites linking to it. The next step is to visit these websites that are linking to it and check where the link is. Why is the link there? Basically, see the context of the link. The reason you want to do this, you find a possible link prospect that is linking to your competitor. You tell them that your link could be relevant to them. You basically want to offer value. To do this, you want to contact the website owner. As you can see an example here, I sent this message and I actually got a link from them. And I did not ask for the link at all. You have to use some psychological copywriting techniques to make sure that people open your email and make sure they're interested and they read it. One link like this counts even more than 100 irrelevant links. People sometimes buy them, people exchange them, whatever they do. But the link like this is super relevant. These are the links that Google wants to see directed to your website. Keep in mind that this technique I've told you, and there are many techniques, works better when you have a page that offers value, like an informational page. And that's it. Now your real estate agent website has gone from SEO level 37, I think I said, to SEO level 77. I like 7. Do you want it to go higher? Do you want it to go to level 100? You can do that if you follow me on YouTube, and most importantly, sign up to my newsletter that is in the description. Now I'm just gonna go to eat, I'm so hungry, and then I will think about my next video idea. Let's go!